So previous class we discussed level generator and polarity generator based reduced switchcount multi-level inverters. So in this class we discuss the next category, that is T-type topologies. My voice is audible, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So in this T-type we have three different types. So one is H-bridge T-type and cascaded T-type. So that is the cascade connection of this H-bridge T-type. And we have this three-phase half-bridge T-type or NPP, neutral point, so pivoted topology. So we'll discuss one by one. So this is the basic T-type topology. So this is for A phase, so this is for B phase, and this is for C phase. Right. So here, so it consists of, so the circuit topology is like this. It consists of two DC sources, right? And this midpoint of this DC source is clamped by a bidirectional switch. And we have this H-bridge arrangement. So this form a T-like structure, and this is an H-bridge. So that's why it is known as T-type H-bridge, or H-bridge T-type topology. So the operation is simple. So we are measuring the voltage between A and this point, or this neutral point, this A and N. We are measuring voltage between A and N, right? So for example, if you want 2V voltage across this A and N, so we need to turn on this switch, and we need to turn on S1 and S4. So this is S1 and this is S4. We need to turn on this S1 and S4 to obtain 2V voltage. Okay. Similarly, if you want to obtain V voltage, so which switch we need to turn on to obtain V voltage? So which switch we need to turn on? If you want V voltage, so which switch we need to turn on? That is between A and N. So which switches we need to turn on? Between
4A, 6A and 5A.
4A, yeah, 4A, this switch and this switch, right? So this 5 and 6. So these switches, so we need to turn on. So these switches we need to turn on to obtain, so this voltage level. So that means we need to turn on, so these two switches and this switch to obtain V voltage level. Similarly for zero voltage level, so which switches we need to turn on? Zero voltage level, so which switches we need to turn on? So for zero voltage level, so we need to turn on these two switches or these two switches, so we can obtain zero voltage level. Similarly for minus V voltage level, so we need to turn on minus V, right? So we need to turn on this S2 and so these switches. If we turn on these two switches, you can obtain minus V voltage level. Similarly for minus 2V voltage level, for minus 2V voltage level, so we need to turn on the switches in the H-bridge. So I think this switch and this switch we need to turn on to obtain minus 2V level across. So this point will be like this. So you can get minus 2V voltage across A and N. So that's why it will produce V, 2V, 0, minus V and minus 2V. So remember, this is a bidirectional switch. The firing pulse for this bidirectional switch is same. So in this bidirectional switch, any one diode and one switch will be conducting. So this is for A phase. Similarly for B phase and C phase, so here these neutral points are connected here. So these neutral points are connected here. So this will be the A phase, this is B phase, and this will be the C phase. So this is for three phase structure. So now The question is, if you want to extend this to higher level, if you want to extend this to higher levels, so there are two possibilities are there. So one possibility is by using cascade connection. So that is, this is one topology, right? So this is one unit. So you have another unit. So these two units we need to connect in cascade, like in cascade CHB, cascade H-bridge. So we have H-bridges are in cascade, right? So here, T-type H-bridges are in cascade. You have another unit. So that unit is cascaded. So like this. So this one, this is the what the cascading cascade connection. So this is a 5 level and this is another 5 level. So these two 5 levels are connected in cascade. So here now we have, this is A phase. So this is the other phase output. So that is connected to this point. And here we are trying to bring out this neutral point or row. Clear? So here to extend this cascaded T-type H-bridge or H-bridge based T-type topology. So one option is to cascade these T-type modules, either these 5-layer modules, we have cascaded 2 modules. So this entire combination will produce how many levels? This entire combination will produce. This is assumed that this is VDC. So this is also VDC. This is VDC. And this is also VDC. So how many levels it can produce?
9
levels, right? Starting from 4 VDC to minus 4 VDC, it can produce 9 levels in the output. So each one will produce 5 levels when you're cascading there. So it will produce 9 levels, right? So this is one way of extending this. The other way of extending is, right? So earlier you have 2 DC sources, right? You have 2 DC sources. So now you have 3 DC sources and you have 2 neutral points. So this is X and this is Y. So X is clamped like this and Y is also clamped like this. So with this combination, you can increase to 7 levels. You can add one more DC source here and you can clamp this one. So it will be another bidirectional switch. So this way you can increase the number of levels. So in this T-type. So there are 2 options. So one is by adding another DC source with another DC source and another bidirectional switch, we can increase the number of levels. Or cascading any 2 modules, you can increase the number of levels. Right. So not only this one, so instead of that, you can replace this here also. Okay. You have one unit like this and you have another unit like this. So that means this will produce 7 levels and this will produce 5 levels. So overall thing will be, the overall output voltage will be varying from, I think, 11 levels. Okay. Starting from 5 VDC to minus 5 VDC. Right. So we can have any kind of configuration. So with this, either we are increasing like this or we are cascading like this. Right. So the important point is, so in this, when you are trying to increase the number of levels, so we need to make sure that, so all these voltages must be equal. So all these voltages must be equal. So that means this is VDC. So this is also VDC and this is also VDC. So that means it will not support this single unit. It will not support asymmetry. But when you're cascading that, so it can support asymmetry. So how it will be means, here you have VDC. So this must be VDC, but you have this VDC and this will be 2. So this is 2 VDC and this is also 2 VDC. So with this combination, so how many levels you can expect?
13
levels, right? That means this will produce 4 VDC, 2 VDC, 0, minus 2 VDC and minus 4 VDC. And this combination will produce 2 VDC, VDC, 0, minus VDC and minus 2 VDC. So this entire thing will be producing 6 VDC to minus 6 VDC. So that means you can get 13 levels. Right. So that means within the module, you have symmetry, right? But when you are cascading that, So you can go for asymmetry. You can even you can go for so 1:3:9 ratio also, since this each module is producing positive and negative voltage levels. So that means each one, so it can be support asymmetrical trinary voltage ratios. Clear? It's clear? So this is T-type topology and its extension. So there is another one, so that is half leg T-type. So this is half leg T-type. This is for three level. This is for three level. So here earlier one, if you compare this with the previous one, so here also you have two DC sources, but this entire unit for three phase. Okay, this entire unit for three phase. The main difference here is in earlier case, when it is a three-phase structure, you can see that the DC sources are separate. This is for A phase, this is for B phase, and this is for C phase. So you require isolated DC supplies for each phase. If you want to operate this one with one single phase or with one with two DC sources, so that means if this DC, if this DC bus is common to all, so in that case, what we have to do is from the load side, you need to isolate, right? So either from the source DC source point of view, you need to isolate, or from the load point of view, you need to isolate. So that means you need to connect transformers at the outputs of this AB0 and AC0. So that means somehow we need to isolation is provided. Okay, so here the DC sources are separate. A phase you have two DC sources, B phase two DC sources, and in C phase you have two more DC sources. But this topology, the DC sources are common, and this is for three phase structure. So this is A phase leg, this entire thing is A phase leg, so this is B phase leg, and this is C phase leg. A phase, this neutral point is connected with a bidirectional switch. In C phase, B phase, this neutral point is connected by a bidirectional switch. So here also in C phase, this neutral point is connected by a bidirectional switch. Right. So how it is working here? So here you can measure the voltage between A and 0. You can measure the voltage between A and 0. So if you measure the voltage between A and 0, it's for example, this must be VDC. If you assume this is also VDC, so in that case, the voltage will be vary from VDC, 0 and minus VDC. It is simple, a three-level diode clamped or flying capacitor inverter, right? It's a simple diode clamped or a flying capacitor three-level inverter, but the circuit topology is different. Right. So now the question is, so if you want VDC across this A and 0, so which device you need to turn on? If you want VDC across this A and 0, so which device you need to turn on?
Yes, one.
So this S1 you need to turn on, right? So as and when you turn on this S1, so this A is connected to this positive plate, so that means you can get A plus VDC voltage across the load. Similarly, to get 0 voltage, so which device you need to turn on to get 0 voltage?
S2.
So 0 voltage you need to turn on this S2, right? This bidirectional switch we need to turn on. To obtain minus voltage, minus VDC voltage,
S3.
So this bottom switch we need to turn on. Clear? So you need to turn on the bottom switch. So that means at any time, so only one switch is conducting. At any point of time, only one switch is conducting. Right? So that is the point. It's clear? So if you compare with, so this diode clamp, earlier we have this diode clamp, right? So for diode clamp for the three level, so how many switches you require? Per phase, how many switches are required? top two switches you require, right? And bottom two switches. So that means four switches you require. In addition to that, two diodes you require, right? Agree?
Yes, sir.
So four active switches and two diodes are required. So here, if you compare this one, so here the total number of switches are four, right? Total number of switches are four, but the diodes are absent here. The diodes are absent here. And another thing is, right, so for this entire switch, only one gate driver is required. So here one gate driver is required. So here one other gate driver is required. This entire thing is one gate driver required. So that means three gate drivers are required. So whereas in diode clamped, four switches are required, four gate drivers required, and two additional diodes or clamping diodes are required, right? And moreover, if you want this full VDC, so how many switches you need to conduct? How many switches you're supposed to operate? You remember that, right? So this is the topology, right? If you want VDC, so how many switches we need to turn on? We need to turn on the upper two switches. When you turn on upper two switches, in that case, you can get the VDC voltage. If you turn on the upper two switches, so then only you will get two VDC voltage. So that means sometimes if you want higher VDC voltage, you need to turn on two switches. So here you need to turn on only one switch. Similarly, for minus VDC in diode clamp, you need to turn on the bottom two switches. So here the bottom two switches are, now you need to turn on only one switch. Similarly, zero voltage, you need to turn on one switch and one diode. So here also, so one diode is in conduction, or one switch will be in conduction. And moreover, the current is bidirectional. Because of this setup, this current is, you can flow in this direction or in this direction. But whereas in diode clamp, it is not possible, right? So that's why we have other topologies, that is active neutral point clamped. So that means the diodes are now replaced with a active switches. So all those are used for have this controlled neutral point current, right? So here also, if you use this, if you have this setup, you can actually the current can be bidirectional. It can flow in both directions depending on the load, means depending on the load polarity. Clear? So that is the advantage. So with this topology, it will reduce the number of components when compared to the diode clamped or flying capacitor multi-level inverters. And other thing is, it can also reduce the switching losses. It can also reduce switching losses. Right. So now the question is, so what is the blocking voltage of this device? What is the blocking voltage of this device? What is the blocking voltage of that device?
VDC.
What is its blocking voltage? So when this is not conducting, right? So assume there are two options are there. This switch will conduct or this switch will conduct. If this is not conducting, this switch will conduct or this switch will conduct. So assume that this switch is conducting. So assume that. So this switch is conducting. So what is its voltage? So how much voltage that appear across if this is conducting, right? So how much voltage that appear across that switch?
VDC.
It's VDC, right? VDC. So this voltage will appear across that switch, right? In second case, if this is conducting, so how much voltage that appear across the switch?
Two VDC,
right? So that means its maximum blocking voltage is 2 VDC. So all these switches, the maximum blocking voltage is 2 VDC. So here also, so the same applies here, right? The same applies here, this bottom switch. So when this top switch is conducting, the bottom switch is supposed to block this 2 VDC. So this is 2 VDC and this is 2 VDC. So now what is the blocking voltage of this bidirectional switch? What is the blocking voltage of that bidirectional switch?
VDC.
VDC, right? So when this S12 is conducting, so it's supposed to block this VDC voltage, or if this is conducting, it's supposed to block this bottom VDC voltage. Right. So this entire block, this one is supposed to block VDC. So that means you have two devices, right? So it will share equally. We assume that we have some equalizing resistors. We have studied, right? So dynamic equalizing resistors are normally connected across switches to equally share the load or equally share the blocking voltage. So theoretically, or most of the times, it will share this VDC by 2 and this device will share VDC by 2. Right. So from this point of view, you can calculate the total standing voltage, right? So what is the total standing voltage of this topology? This entire thing. We have 2 VDC, 6 VDC, so that is 12 VDC, right? So 12 VDC by plus 3 bidirectional switches. So each one is supposed to cater 3 VDC, right? That is 3 VDC. So that means 15 VDC is its blocking voltage. That means total standing voltage for 3 phase. Total standing voltage for 3 phase. It's clear? It's clear?
Yes.
So this is one of the best alternative for the diode clamped in recent times. So this is one of the best alternative for the diode clamp. So this is also known as neutral point pivoted topology, NPP, neutral point pivoted topology. And the drawback is obviously this must be symmetrical. So this whatever the DC source here, it must be same. So that means it will not support asymmetry. It will not support asymmetry, and when compared to this diode clamped, so the losses will be low, and the cost is also much less when compared to this diode clamp. So this is one of the best alternative for the 3-level diode clamped inverter. All right. So before going to that. So first we'll discuss, so this is known as hexagonal switch cell, or HSC, hexagonal switch cell. So this is obtained by extending the H-bridge. Extending the H-bridge. So this S1, this S6, S4, S6, so along with DC source, so it will form an H-bridge, right? So with addition to that, so they added 2 more switches, this S2 and S5, and this DC source, and this entire thing will form an hexagon. So that's why it is known as hexagonal switch cell. It is known as hexagonal switch cell. Right. So the circuit will be like this. You have this is one DC source and the other DC source, so that is connected in opposite to that. So that means at some point of time, so these 2 DC sources will be in series, right? These 2 DC sources will be in series to produce the output voltage, which is equal to VDC 1 plus VDC 2, right? So if you want to connect these 2 DC sources in series, right, and you are measuring the voltage across A and 0, so which switches you need to turn on? Got it right. So I need to connect VDC 1 plus, I mean I need to obtain VDC 1 plus VDC 2 across A and 0. So which switches you need to turn on? One.
2S.
1 and which switches you need to turn on? Like this? Like this you are saying? Like this? So how much voltage will appear across A and 0?
VDC 1 plus VDC.
This is A, right? Okay. So this is point is connected here. So that means these two will be in series, right? This is plus minus and this is plus minus. So you're connecting, if you're going like this, right? So that means it's plus minus and plus minus. So that's why both are in series. So that means you need to turn on the switches S1, S5 and S3. S1, S5 and S3. So that will produce plus, if you assume that, so this is VDC. So this is also VDC. You can obtain actually 2 VDC. Right. So but if you want only VDC, so which switches you need to turn on? Only VDC. Only VDC, right? So this switches we need to turn on, right? It will go like this. That means you need to bypass one DC source, or you can also use this DC source. If you want zero voltage, so which switches we need to turn on for zero voltage?
Zero voltage.
So these S4 three you can S4 turn S4. On, or is these three you can turn on, right? To obtain zero voltage. Similarly, minus of minus 2 VDC voltage, so which device we need to turn on? Minus 2 VDC. S1, S4. Will it be like this? Will it be like this? Agree?
Yes, sir.
Right. So it will produce minus 2 VDC, or in other words, minus of VDC 1 plus VDC 2. That means it will produce, actually it is producing minus of VDC 1 plus VDC 2. So that means each unit is producing 5 levels. So each unit is producing 5 levels, starting from 2 VDC, VDC 0, minus VDC and minus 2 VDC. Right. So for this, how many switches are added? We added only 2 switches and 1 DC source, right? So we obtained 5 levels. If you compare with cascade H bridge, if you compare with cascade H bridge, if you want 5 level, you required to connect 2 H bridges in cascade. So that means you required 8 number of switches, but here you require only 6 number of switches. You require only 6 number of switches. That means 2 switches are reduced. So that is the advantage with this hexagonal switch cell. And another interesting thing is it will operate with asymmetry. So that means if you assume this is VDC and it can work with 2 VDC. Right. It can work with 2 VDC. If you want 3 VDC, we can obtain this, right? Earlier we obtained, right, 2 VDC path. So this is the path for 2 VDC, right? 3 VDC. This is the path for 3 VDC. Similarly, if you want 2 VDC path, so 2 VDC path, I think. So we need to operate this switch, right? So we need to operate something like this. This switch we need to operate, and this switch we need to operate, right? So this will gives you plus 2 VDC, correct? Is this correct?
Yes, sir.
This correct, right? We need to operate something like this. You can obtain, so 2 VDC. If you want only VDC, either you can operate 2 VDC minus VDC, or you can operate, so this VDC alone. If you operate this VDC alone, so you can obtain like this, or you can operate 2 VDC minus VDC also. For 0 voltage, it is same. Again, this is for 0 voltage. This is like this, we have to operate. Okay, so that means this will support asymmetry. It will support asymmetry, but it will support only 1:2 ratio. It will support 1:2 ratio. If it is 1:3 ratio, so it won't support for 1:3 ratios usually. Okay, so usually it is known as VR or VS. In general, it is normally designated with VS, and this is VR. So this is VS and this is VR. In other words, it is sending end voltage and this is receiving end voltage, but the polarities are reversed here. So this is the thing about this hexagonal switch cell. So this hexagonal switch cell can be increased its level something like this by connecting two hexagonal switch cells or two HSE units in cascade. We can actually increase the number of levels. So this is the cascade connection of one HSE with another HSE. So this will produce 5 levels, this will produce 5 levels, this entire thing will produce 9 levels. So with this basics on that, so we have the other type of inverters are there. This is based on HSC plus T type. So this is a hybrid unit. These are known as hybrid T type topologies. So these are basically obtained by hybridizing HSC unit with T type. See here, this is HSC unit, right? This entire thing is HSC unit. So this is T type. So this thing is T-type unit. So we are connecting to these two. So how it is operating? Right. So how it is operating? So this is actually producing 9 levels. This is actually producing 9 levels. So if we assume this is VDC. So this is also VDC if we assume that. So how much, what is the voltage of this one? How much voltage it will generate? If this is VDC, so what should be this voltage?
By
2. So this is VDC, right? So two capacitors are connected across VDC. That means this is VDC by 2 and this is also VDC by 2. Right? So this is VDC by 2 and this is also VDC by 2. Right? So now the maximum voltage that can be obtained by adding these two DC sources. So that it gives you 2 VDC voltage. If we add this sum of these two DC sources, it gives you 2 VDC, right? And another one is you can add this DC source plus this one, so that gives you 1.5 VDC. And you have single VDC or either this one or this one, so that gives you VDC and minus 0.5 VDC with this only capacitors. If you have this capacitors, right, you can actually get AN0, you can get this VDC by 2, right? So 0.5 VDC. So how to get 0.5 VDC with this? Which switches you need to turn on between A and 0? Yes. Which switches we need to turn on if you want only 0.5 VDC? So this is 0.5 VDC, right? So this is like this. Okay, if you turn on these switches, so this is actually producing 0.5 VDC. Agree?
Yes, sir.
Right. So here zero, again for zero, you need to turn on these three switches or these bottom three switches. And similarly, you have minus 0.5 VDC. So minus 0.5 VDC, how to obtain minus 0.5 VDC? So this simply operate this one. You can get minus 0.5 VDC, and after that you have minus VDC, minus 1.5 VDC and minus 2 VDC. So that means how many levels? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. That means you can get 9 levels. Clear? The idea is when you have only HSC unit, one HSC unit, you can get 5 levels. Right? So but this DC is splitted, right? By this DC splitted by using a T-type circuit. This DC splitted by using a T-type circuit. So therefore, the number of this access points is increased, right? So it's supposed to produce 2 VDC, VDC, 0, minus VDC and minus 2 VDC. But it is generating some intermediate voltages. So this is producing half of the voltage so that the levels can be increased between 2 VDC to minus 2 VDC. Okay, so there is no change in the peak voltage. There is no change in the peak voltage, but the steps are increased. This HSE unit is also producing 2 VDC to minus 2 VDC. So this is also producing output voltage between plus 2 VDC to minus 2 VDC. But the difference is the number of steps are increased. Earlier the step change is VDC. So now it is reduced to 0.5 VDC. So how that 0.5 VDC is obtained? By using this additional unit. So by using this extra unit or this using this unit, so you actually obtain the 0.5 VDC step size. Okay, it's clear? Clear?
Yes.
Yes.
Sir, the second leg switches are supposed to be opposite to what we use, is it, sir?
Mm-hmm. Second leg switches?
They are like opposite to what we generally use in HPHT.
Yeah, these switches are opposite to this. These switches are like this only. Okay.
Oh, because of was it same switch for hexagonal also?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, same. I think same.
Oh.
I think I've not drawn it properly. Let me check once. It's supposed to be in the opposite direction. Just a moment, let me check once. We have this. It is usually in the opposite direction, I guess. Yeah, this is the one. This is visible, right?
Yes, sir. Yes.
The screen is visible. So this is in the opposite direction. Okay. It's supposed to be opposite direction. So maybe I'm drawn wrong in that.
Thank you.
Okay. So this is in opposite direction, right? Yeah. So actually these switches are in opposite direction. These switches are in actually opposite direction. Okay. I think here I drawn properly. So this is about hybrid T-type. So there are several variants in this hybrid T-type. So this is one of the variant. So now to increase the number of levels, so in this hybrid T-type, so we have something like this, right? So here, so this is same structure, but this DC is divided into now four parts. If this is VDC, so now it is divided into four parts. So VDC by four. So each one is VDC by four. So here the step size is reduced. Still it is producing the output from plus 2 VDC to minus 2 VDC, but the step size is reduced to VDC by four. So that means, so it can produce, I think 17 level, right? This entire thing can produce 17 level in the output voltage. The step size is now reduced and this entire thing will produce 17 level in the output voltage. So this is one way to extension. So the other way is just cascade these two units. So this is one unit and this is another unit. So if we cascade these two units, you can also extend to higher levels. So one is to increase this DC source or this capacitors with this bidirectional switches, or other way to increase this cascade these several units. So this topology, so usually support asymmetry, right? So this topology usually support asymmetry. So when this topology is known as asymmetry, we already said that this is Vs and this is Vr, right? If this Vs equal to Vr, right? If this Vs is equal to Vr, so then this topology is symmetrical. This both are same. This is symmetrical. If this is, for example, if Vs, for example, this is 2 VDC and this is VDC. If not, so then it is asymmetrical. Clear? So both are same, this one and this one both are same, so then it is symmetrical, otherwise it is asymmetrical. So we have another one, right? So another one, so this is another one. The difference is, so earlier you have one side, right? So this capacitor, this Vs is split into two parts earlier. So now this Vr is also split into two parts. This Vr is also split into two parts. So this is Vdc by 2. And this is also Vdc by 2. That is minus Vdc by 2. And this is also minus Vdc by 2. Clear? So why the idea is, so when you are doing that, that there is no change in the number of levels, still it is producing 9 number of levels, but it will increase the redundancies. So how it will increase the redundancies means, if you want only 0.5 VDC, you can operate this one, or else you can operate this one. Okay, so this will increase the number of redundancies. Still it is producing plus 2 VDC to minus 2 VDC, and the step size is 0.5 VDC, and it will produce 9 levels. But when compared to this one, so when compared to this one, what we discussed, right? So here only one side of H bridge, HSC unit, we have this T type, whereas here this T type extension is on both sides. So by doing this, the number of levels are still same, but the switching redundancies will be greatly increased. So this is another idea to implement hybrid T type with HSE unit. So this extension is like this. So this is one type of extension, right? By using different bidirectional switches and clamping it, so each midpoint of that. So that is one way. Or you can cascade these two units. Or actually you can cascade, so any of these two units. Right. So next, these are about this T-type topologies. These are about this T-type topologies. So next we have this ladder-based structures, or some staircase-based structures. Yeah. So this we discussed, right? T-type topologies. So next we have this ladder-based structures. So one is CBSC, and this is switched DC sources STS, and this is packed UCL, so this is PUC. So these are, so it look like a ladder, right? So this means normally known as ladder based structures. So this is the first one, CBSC. So this is based on, so bidirectional switches. So this is with unidirectional switches, right? So we'll discuss one by one. Yeah, this first one, so this is CBSC, that is cascaded bipolar switched cell. Cascaded bipolar switched cell. So this is S1, the switches are organized like this. So S1, S2, S3, S4, S5, S6. So all these things are bidirectional switches. So we are measuring the voltage between A and B, A and 0, or we are connecting the load between this A and 0. So now, so how it will operate is just simple, right? If you want to connect all these three DC sources in series, the path will be like this. If you want to connect all the three DC sources in series, so the path will be like this. So that will produce plus 3 VDC. So that will produce plus 3 VDC. And if you want to operate with only 2 VDC, if you want to operate with 2 VDC, so if the path will be like this. The path will be like this. If you want only VDC, the path will be like this. So that means you are bypassing two switches. Similarly, for negative voltages also, for negative voltages, you need to operate like this. So if you want 3 VDC, you need to operate like this for negative voltages. So this will produce minus 3 VDC. And if you want only this one, you need to bypass this. This produces minus VDC. And this one will produce minus 2 VDC. Right. So here the polarity generator is not required. So this entire unit is producing, so how many levels? 7 levels. So this is producing 7 levels. And interesting thing is, it will also support asymmetry, right? It will also support asymmetry, but it will not support binary or trinary. So only arithmetic progression it will support, and that too, it must be in this ratio. It must be 2 VDC, and this is the middle one is 3 VDC, and this is 2 VDC. It must be in this form, so then only it will produce the desired number of levels. So then only this will produce the desired number of levels. If you want only 3 VDC, right? For example, if you want 3 VDC, the path will be like this. If you want 3 VDC, the path will be like this. If you want 2 VDC, the path will be like this. So that's why it will produce limited asymmetry. So now the question is, so come to the blocking voltages, right? So now, what is the blocking voltage for this switch S1? So what is the maximum blocking voltage? So for this switch S1. So now we'll try to calculate. So this will, for example, this is operating like this. So how much voltage it will produce? Minus 3 VDC, right? So in this case, what is the blocking voltage of this switch S1? When it is producing minus 3 VDC or plus 3 VDC, what is the blocking voltage for the switch S1?
3 VDC.
It's supposed to block this entire voltage, right? It's supposed to block this entire voltage, so that is 3 VDC. Similarly, this switch is also 3 VDC and this switch is also 3 VDC. Right. So, but the switches in these switches, is supposed to block this difference of these two voltages, right? So these switches are intermediately connected, right? It's supposed to block the difference of two voltages. All these outer switches are supposed to block 3 VDC and the inner switches are supposed to block only VDC. So with this 2:3:1 ratio, so it will produce a 13 level output. Right. So this is about this cascaded bipolar switch itself. So we have another one. So that is switched DC sources. This is SDS. Switched DC sources. The circuit will be like this. So we assume that this is VDC and this is all these DC sources are equal. For this first case, it can actually produce 7 levels starting from VDC, 3 VDC to minus 3 VDC. So how it will be means, so it will be like this, right? It will go like this and it will be like this in zigzag fashion. So it will start from here, it will like this, it will go like this and it will be like this. So if you notice that this is minus plus, right? So this is minus plus and this is minus plus, I think. So it is going from minus to plus, right? So that means all the 3 DC sources are in series. So it will produce the desired voltage. Clear? So if you want only 2 VDC, right? If you want to bypass the switch, you can bypass any of the switch, something like this. You can actually bypass, you have bypassed this VDC3 right now. If you want only VDC, it is simple. I think only VDC can be obtained like this. So only VDC can be obtained like this. If you start like this, right? I think if you start like this, you can go like this. Okay. So here sometimes the switch will conduct. Here the switch is conducting. So in this case, this diode is in conduction. Here the diode is in conduction. Sometimes the switches are in conduction. Sometimes the diode is actually in conduction here. So this is about the switched DC sources, SDS, the switched DC sources. It's clear? So here also it will not support asymmetry, right? So but if you have different voltage ratio, this is VDC, 2 VDC and 3 VDC, but it will produce, can actually produce 13 level output voltage. Can actually produce 13 level output voltage with this kind of arrangement. So another one is this PUC, the packed U cell. This is another one, so that is PUC. Right. So here the voltage ratio is different, right? So it looked like this earlier one, what we discussed earlier, right? But the switching combinations, if you notice that, so the polarity of the switches are different here. The polarity of switches are different. If you notice that these are alternatively plus minus and alternatively plus, right? But here all the DC sources in the same direction. So earlier one, we have plus minus and minus plus, something like this, right? But here all are in one direction. You have positive here and positive here. So earlier you have positive, negative and positive, negative. So that is the main difference. And here, right, if you assume this is VDC, so this is also VDC and this is also VDC, right? So all are VDC. So it can produce the maximum voltage is very less, right? If it is all are same, for example, it is all are same. So in that case, what will happen if you are going like this and like this, right? So what is the maximum voltage you can get? What is the voltage in this case? If you're trying to connect all the DC sources, so what is the voltage you can get?
3V.
2V DC.
See here, this is minus plus, right? This is minus plus. So this is plus minus. So that will be cancelled out, right? So that means you're left with only one source. So that means it is changing from plus VDC to minus VDC. So the same thing is written here, right? So with this symmetrical arrangement, so that means whenever the DC sources are symmetrical, so in that case, the output voltage is always restricted to plus VDC to minus VDC. The output voltage is always restricted to plus VDC to minus VDC only, because two DC sources are connected in opposite direction. So therefore the output voltage is reduced. Right, so but you have this kind of difference, this is VDC and this is 3VDC, and if this is 6VDC, so something like this. So in this case, we are operating like this, so how much voltage you can get? So this is VDC and this is 3VDC, right? So that means you have this different voltage, so that means, so how much voltage you can get actually? So with this arrangement, you can actually get 4VDC, right? So that means you can actually get 4VDC. Or if you are operating only this DC source, so how much voltage you can get? 6VDC. If you are operating only that DC source, you can have 6VDC. So that means the output voltage is changing from 6VDC to minus 6VDC. The output voltage is changing from 6VDC to minus 6VDC when it is 1:3:6 ratio, right? So generally this topology is not well considered because of this drawbacks, right? If this is 6VDC, right, so that means each switch is supposed to block for 6VDC, and moreover, when you compare this one, right, when you compare this one, this is VDC, this is 2VDC and this is 3VDC, right? The maximum voltage is always 6VDC. With 1:2:3 ratio, you're actually getting 6VDC. But here with 1:3:6 ratio, you're supposed to get 10VDC, right? You're supposed to get sum of all this, right? So instead of 10VDC, you're getting only 6VDC. So that means it is always operating in buck mode. It is always operating in buck mode. So because the DC source arrangement, so this topology is generally not preferred. And this is about these topologies, and we have another topologies that we'll discuss in the next class. Yeah, some other topologies are there. So one is this switched capacitor topologies and three-phase topologies. And we will discuss these things in the next class. We'll take another half an hour time. Right? So you have any doubts on this? You have any doubts here?
sir, what is the full form of CBSC?
It is given, right?
No, sir, I didn't notice it.
I think I have written on that.
So, yes, cascaded bipolar cells, sir.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Cascaded bipolar cells. See, here there are numerous topologies, more than 100 topologies or 150 topologies right now they are presenting. So all these things are replacement for the conventional multi-level inverters. Most of them are not successful, right? For example, this topology, whatever we discussed, right? So this is, the SDS is one of the best topology, right? So at the same time, we have this PUC, right? So this is one of the worst topology, right? Okay. So we need to judge, so which one is best or which one is not good, right? Similarly, this one, whatever, this is one of the best topology. And here also, this hybrid T-type, so this is also one of the best topology because you are getting 9 levels, so with less number of switches. Moreover, these are 2 capacitors only, right? You have 2 DC sources you are using, and how many additional switches are, 8 additional switches are using. So with 8 additional switches, so you are getting more voltages, and the blocking voltages of the switches is also is clamped to this VDC only. The blocking voltage is also less in this. So therefore, some of the topologies are really good. Okay, any other doubts?